Welcome, and thank you for joining me today to learn more about chakras. And today I'll go over what a chakra is, why we should keep them balanced, and some easy ways we can cooperate in our daily lives, which are very busy, I know, to help balance our chakras. And I'm Robin LaRue, and again, thank you for joining me. I'm a wife, a mother, and a grandmother, Mame, to four beautiful, inquisitive little beings. And I also own a garden supply store with my daughter. And I work part-time at our literacy department in our local library. So I just wanted to give you a little information about me, because I've always loved all kinds of energy healing, like meditation and Reiki and yoga, Tai Chi, and of course chakras. So hopefully this will give you some information on what chakras are. And what they are actually is they're just centers of energy that flow in our body and vibrate at certain frequencies. And we are all made up of energy. So we are always in communication with everyone else's energy and vibrations around us. So the chakras are, they actually hold intelligence and support and influence specific aspects of our body, physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. And sometimes we even refer to the energy like around us as our aura. You might have heard of that. So when we balance our chakras, then we can bring our own energy back into balance, so that everything around us kind of in sync with us, so we can help others also just by balancing our own energy. And energy cannot be created or destroyed, it just is. However, we can easily shift it and change its form. So kind of think of clouds floating around and visualize how seamlessly they transform and rearrange themselves and just move around. So that helps us, you know, keep an idea of how we can quickly and easily change our own energy. So there are seven primary chakra centers. We have our root chakra, which is based at the base of our spine. We have our sacral, which is about an inch or two below our belly button. We have our solar plex, which is an inch or two above our belly button. We have our heart chakra. We have our throat chakra. We have our third eye, which is also referred to as the brow chakra sometimes. And then we have our crown chakra. So each chakra has a physical and mental and emotional need associated with it. So when we get them in balance, we can make ourselves healthier. And these energy centers can become unbalanced, and they can be blocked or underactive, or they can be open and overactive. So when this happens, we're not in balance, and that often leads to illness or even emotional issues that we might have come up in our life. So we can't always control things around us, but we can control how we react to those things and respond in a healthy way. And keeping our chakras balanced is can definitely help us achieve optimal health. And in our busy lives, we can use things quickly and easily to help us get back in balance. We can use gemstones. I love crystals and gemstones. You can just either hold them in your hands or wear them or you know, sit and meditate with them. You can just put them in your pocket and carry them around with you for the day. It's kind of like a worry stone too. I like the smooth ones. Everyone has their own preferences. So we can use gemstones or crystals. We can use essential oils to help us with our moods and lift us up and balance our chakras. Even yoga and meditation and mantras can help us raise our vibrations or lower our vibrations, depending on what we need to do with our chakras. So, crown chakra can help us stay healthy. So if you found this information helpful, I'd like you to stay tuned for a few of my other videos on all the individual chakras and how we can balance them easily in our daily life. So I hope you are well. Thank you for joining me.